Nick, Oleg, Bobba, David, Rasha, Matt, Darren, Keith, Andy, Hype, Hype, Hype. Excited for this. Very excited for this. Zach, Chris, Charles, how you doing? Gotta go for an emergency toilet break before we even start, so it's not technically a break, but you know what it is. BRB. Good luck. Oof. It's nothing. It's just a... just riding indoors. Ain't nothing but a peanut. Towel, water, fan. Thank you. No, I'm sure. I doubt I'll make this look like a breeze. I doubt I'll make this a breeze. We've entered a different... well, we've got different competition every day, so that doesn't make it very easy. The start list is very difficult for this. Those of you who might have seen already some of the names on here. Yeah, we've got Scott Uice, just to name one. We've got former 2018 Zwift, USA Zwift champion. In Zimmerman, Mr. Zimmerman. So it's not a... we've got... yeah, well, goes without saying that there's some strong riders in this event. So I've got the Millenstein wheels on, yeah. I mean, there's more climbing in this than anything else in terms of like the overall distance, and the amount of time will actually be top climbing, so I've gone for them. I don't think I am third on GC, Ian. I wouldn't have thought so. And there's no way I'm going to be beating my personal best at the Alp 34 minutes. That was 6 watts per kilo, that was, remember. And there's no way I can do 6 watts per kilo for 34 minutes now. So we're looking anything between like 35 and 40 minutes. That's what we're looking for. You know, I'd be amazed if my effort is half decent up the Alp. because I mean, the people in this race, I'm gonna have to let them do their thing. They're like, if they wanna hit the hard at the bottom, see you later. I'm not doing that. I'm riding my own Alp. Yeah, Brett is in this race as well. Accumulated fatigue, remember?
My weight right now is like 60.5. Hey, Giorgio. Yeah, we've got for the lightweight Millersteins. You have to remember we're going around the jungle as well, the long way around, so. Yeah, we don't just go straight to the Alp. We can go around. So, it is what it is. I reckon 37, 38 minutes will be a fairly decent time on the Alp if I can manage that, but. Yeah, we'll see how we go. How did I manage to stay so close to race weight, even with COVID? Well, during COVID, I didn't eat anything. Me and Charlie basically didn't eat. Like, you just didn't feel like eating, you didn't eat, and you just maintained the same weight. And, you know, I'm young. So, you know, a lot of people say, well, weight is easier to maintain when you're younger. And also, you know, I'm pretty in tune with like how I eat and when I eat and how I feel, and it just kind of hovers in that range now. How am I planning on attacking the Alp? You'll have to stick around and wait. No, I'm gonna pace it. It'll be very well paced. That's all I can say. I'm not going to be doing anything special at the bottom of the Alp. So you won't have to cheer me on at the bottom, you'll have to cheer me on at the top. Just keep me company at the bottom, like, keep my mind occupied at the bottom for me. That's all I ask for you. In the jungle, the mighty jungle, the Niels is the DS. How the legs feeling? I don't know. Can't answer that question until we start riding. I feel alright. I felt okay all day. But we won't really know until we start going hard. And then you'll know then, I think. You'll know, I'll know. Alright, here we go then. The alpaca. Good luck to Matt as well. There's Matt James. Good luck to Matt. Give him hell, buddy. If I don't engage as much, with the chat, it's because I'm concentrating. Yeah, Boniface is in this race. Hey Kev. Almost a full squad. Who's missing then? It's quite warm in here already. The sun in Wales is pointing into my room. It's a sign. Oh, the fan is on. There's Quentin. Good job, mate. Paris, terrible. Oh Lord, you won't believe the weather here, buddy. It is awesome. Yeah, and I've also got an Amazon Basics tower fan. David Talbot's in there. Seems to be sitting out behind. Scorchio. It is Scorchio. First little obstacle of this race is this climb coming up. Very short one, quite shallow, so you can draft up it, but it does get strung out. I'm good, Graham, thank you. Not so bad. Here we go. Keep myself in the draft. Okay, someone goes for it. Quentin, move up. First climb done. Watts per kilo is a piece of cake. Lots of power-ups being used. I got nothing yet. Someone's gone off the front. Bit of a split in the field. So the tactic for this stage today, I'm gonna follow up the radio tower. And if it starts getting a bit too spicy, I'm going to immediately settle into my own rhythm and, you know, play that by ear. And then what's going to happen then is I'll have to find myself a group to get around the jungle and then, well, the Alp is every man for himself, isn't it? Or every woman for themselves, of course. So I'm gonna, I think it's gonna be your own race on the Alp, so I'm gonna ride my own race. If you see me taking it carefully at the bottom, that's part of the plan. Like, I'm gonna take... Oh, did I say radio tower? No, there is no radio tower. I've done it too many times, that's why I keep saying it. I did mean the epic, yeah. So yeah, that's the plan. So, you know, it's almost like a time trial. You know, the Alp. You know, I think I'll ride, if it stays together for the first couple of hairpins, you know, I'll ride with the group. But if it's any funny business, I'm gonna ride my own pace instantly. I've got an opportunity to set a personal best power up the Alp for the last 90 days, which will give me some good accurate data to work with. So I'm not going to be stupid and throw all out the window trying to follow somebody at the bottom. I have faith. Good luck, Pascal. No pressure, David. Also, you remember what happened yesterday? Like, it's quite motivational when you have people to chase. The race ends on top of the Alp. Hold on, Camus with the ride on. Coming to the end of Phil's favourite bit of road. Well, it's almost straight on to the epic. No messing around. Good luck, Hugh. Good luck, Matt. I guess do it. What's my PR on the Alp? I think it's 34 minutes, 11 seconds, roughly. Not now, no. Here we go. I'm guessing this is going to be really hard into the bottom. I'm a bit worried. This is a bit easy. For the group, I mean. Like, everyone's like, oh. Big old Alf coming. Everyone's gonna be like Freddy Fresh Legs going up the last climb. I'll try not to get dropped. Job, Q. Keep grinding it, Matt. Every second counts. At the top of the epic, in my opinion. Yeah. Use your head. I'm not giving up. Use your head, guys. And it's now splitting apart up there. Thank you. Well, Tommy, if I wanted to win a bike race, I wouldn't do what Matthew Van Der Poel did. Oh, good Q, come on. Go on, Q. You're nearly there. Q. It's easing up. Well done, mate. Q was in this race. He's my teammate. Big group. Big group. It's good, isn't it? Big group. What's he saying chase for? Why bother chasing? We're a huge group. And we've got a 35, 40 minute climb coming up. If you're saying chase and you're strong enough, you should have been in the front group in the first place. Ooh, Ed Ray is going to be tough to close down then. Thanks for that, Zach. K to go. Psychopath reckons we'll catch on the dirt. We will see. Long way to go. Switch your mountain bike. I'm pretty warmed up now, yeah. See you, Derek. You believe in me, thank you. I mean, they must be alright at the front if they're typing. They must be feeling good. Make Ed do the chasing back, ha! That's having a laugh. I'm in no way contributing to this. Yeah, Kevin was leading the GC, but they hadn't updated the GC. Like, even my time from yesterday wasn't on there. So, how's it feeling? Things are okay at the minute. I've already said I'm gonna have to play it carefully. I'll be out. My FTP is apparently 340 now, 345. I mean, you think I'm making it look easy, I'm not, like, this is uncomfortable. I know my heart rate's low, but it's a comfortable, uncomfortable pace here. Got a cue. Got a cue. Q. Legs are alright at the minute. Reassess that with 2k to go. Yeah, my intention is not to make it look easy. Because it's all relative. Thank you, Melvin. I don't know, but the gap is pretty big now, yeah? To the front group. I'm going to plan to ride the Alp at around 330 watts and then gradually ramp it up. So it'll be about 5.5 watts per kilo, give or take, I think. I've got an excuse now not to ride, because Q's up the road. That's it, Derek, that's it. Also, I have a third cadence, about 85 to 90. A 1 minute gap to the front group is a good gap. There'll be some nice carrots. Although, it's unlikely that I'll get to that front group now. Unless they really blow at the top. I mean, in theory, like, if I'm going to be doing 5.5, some of them in the front group are going to have to be going harder than that to hold the gap, because if I've got enough to ramp at the end, they're going to be pulled back. But 49 seconds is a huge gap, so we'll see. I won't be able to do it without you. 500 of you, you've got to press a like button, because a like equals what? Good effort, Q. Good effort, Q. Well done, buddy. Oh, that's better. Cold on the skin. Oh, that's a good power up there. Zimmerman pulled out. Cheers, Steve. Sorry about the bare chest for all the female viewers. And all the male viewers, actually. Now is not a good time to ask for advice. Good job, Q, buddy, good job. Ah, the Alp, we must go. The gap is 1 minute. Just 5.5 km, if you can do it. Not 5.5 up the kilo. You guys are going to have to keep me updated on the time gap because I can't see it. Yes. Roger that. Q, don't ride any harder. Don't pull any harder. Keep it at 5.5 for you, Q. Don't worry about me. How far to go is turn 15? What's the distance to the finish? Yeah, how far? Never mind. Do this flat section coming up here. Don't peel off yet. Peel off after the flat bit. Okay. Oh, I give that everything. I give it absolutely everything there. Yeah, thank you for the ride on free draft, Ed. Sorry. Oh my. Oh my word. Oh, wrong one. Sounds about a minute and a half slower than my all time best. But I don't care about that. What I care about was that effort. My word. Q. If I had a hat. Hats off, Q. Hats off. Hats off, Q. That was immense. That was immense, Q. I was alright, like, you were pulling, like, reasonably hard, and I just about kind of, I was on your wheel, but I was like, well, this is, like, feeling a bit uncomfortable, and it's usually, you're probably gonna laugh when I say that, but it feels uncomfortable because I'm not used to the effort yet. I need to ride myself in it. Oh, Craig, thank you for the five. Oh, my word. But I was like, as soon as Q pulled off, like that was like, you know, 30% of the climb already done. So in my head, like, Q made that so easy because I only have to follow him and then do my own thing when he leaves. And so it makes a massive difference when you ride with somebody else. Is that 45 seconds faster? That's awesome. Cheers, Sam. So I'll pull the graph up in a minute. If those of you that are new here, at the end of every Zwift race, we have a look at the graph. We have a little guess in game for the TSS, your training stress score. And then we just have like a quick chat about what happened, really. It'd be interesting to see what my best 20 minute was in there, because if it's anywhere over 350, then that's a new FTP technically. An actual number rather than a modeled number. It's hard to tell, like, if you would have caught them. I mean, we were definitely closing in really fast at the end to first place, but like, we were actually like, I think second place, Ed the draft, I think he would have held on personally. He was doing a solid ride, so TSS has got to be close to 150, I'd say, like, at least 150. So, you know, am I stuck there? Am I not moving? Oh, thank you. Thank you, Agnes. I'll pass that on. Why aren't I moving? What's going on here? Oh, there I am. I am moving. It just took me ages to get out of shot. Let's have a quick stop here. Don't worry, I will descend. I will descend the Alp. I just want to have a look at the map view also before we start moving. Q got a top 10. Nice one, Q. That's solid. So we're going to have a quick look now then at the graph. Shut up. My palm here must be broken. Wahoo, send me a new kicker. Something wrong with this one. 3-6-2. Get out. Thank you, Ian. How on earth can that be 3-6-2 for the final 20 minutes? You're witnessing, like, you're witnessing somebody going from basically a fitness level that they had 8 years ago to being almost back potentially I wouldn't say nowhere near full fitness, but you're actually watching something unfold. Oh my word, that, what on earth is that? That is just art, isn't it? That is just art. For any of you watching, I'm riding on like 40% trainer difficulty, so that's why my power is so smooth. It makes it easier on the Alp to have a good chain line and feel like you can ride a good effort. If I was 100% training difficulty, I'd be like, I'd probably blow my knees out at the end of 3 days. I'm not conditioned to do it yet. So let's have a look at this. This is the critical power now, so this is going to be, oh my word, it keeps going. Oh my word, no, it's not possible.
What? How's that? We're still alive.
Woohoo! You happy?
We're happy.
Yeah.
I can't believe it.
I still have to shower, by the way.
Han?
I still have to shower.
Go on then. I'll wrap this up now.
Well, I'm cooking dinner at the moment.
Alright. Can I have a muffin?
Yes.
I'll come in and get it.
No,
don't bring it in. I can't believe that. It's even closer there. It's only blooming 3 watts. I can't put into words, like, what that... No, I'm just being cheesy, you know, like... It's just that, like... Do you know when you've, like, worked really hard to, like, race... Like, in races and, like, try to be the best you can possibly be, and then something comes along that's completely out of your control and just takes it all away? And fitness is a weird thing because it, you can train it, you can plan it, and sometimes it just comes for no apparent reason whatsoever. And sometimes it can take forever to finally materialize. But this is just like... Like... Some of you were saying like that it's ingrained in me, and it's if I was there must be something in me that does this. Surely this isn't like normal. Like, well, we'll see, won't we? Like, we'll see what happens in the next couple of months. So if I'm doing this now, say goodbye and eat your muffin. I think I will. As Phil Lovett says, it's been proper emotional. Yeah, that high volume block has definitely done something, hasn't it? You know, whether it's allowed me to go harder because I've been slightly fresher because of less intensity, or, you know, well, it could have just been right time, you know, right time to do it. It just happened to be the right time to do that volume, and everything has kind of fallen perfectly after that. I certainly think... you know, there's more to it. I think, you know, doing the numbers I'm doing on a comeback like this, I think there's more to it. I keep saying it all the time, but there's a lot, you know, my history in this sport, racing and training for as many years as I have, it's done a lot for me, you know. Yeah. What goes first near the end, legs or lungs? My legs were going, although I can't say one went before the other. I paced it really well. My legs were just kind of, it's a long time to be doing an effort, you know, like, you know, I 100% like understand a lot of you, you know, you're going flat out for almost an hour to get up this Alp. You know, I'm going up it in 35 minutes. You know, I completely get that. You know, your efforts are technically harder than mine, but the fatigue that you build up by being right on the ragged edge for 35 minutes, 40 minutes, 50 minutes, an hour, like, that's what really gets you, you know, right at the end, is, you know, you're like, you want more, but there's like, your legs have literally been, you know, the lactic acid has been, you know, it's been slowly building and building, and then when you start to really ramp up the last bit, there really is no, you know, there's no getting away from the effort. You know, for me, it's the legs rather than the heart rate. It depends. If I'm fresh, it's the heart rate. But if at the end of an effort like that, it's the legs. So yeah, Dirk. But you're getting stronger every day, buddy. You're getting stronger every day, and that's what it's all about, isn't it? Good riding as well, Mr. Ben Pitt. Good riding this weekend from you. Been following along on Strava. Good job. And you too, Keith. Everybody else has been riding. Super job. I'm going to go and lie down. we highly positive split now. Good job, Kieran. That was brilliant. That warrants a lie down and some fries. Thank you, Adrian. I appreciate that. Thank you. Can we get it to 350 likes? Are we on now? 296. There's 350 watching now. Lord demands 350 likes. Nice one, Keith. We got a week of training this week. Not too much because we have a stage race on RGT next weekend. A couple of people in the chat are doing it as well. It's gonna be fun. And yeah, it's going to be different to Zwift, so I feel like I'm going to get a few questions from people asking what it is. I'll make it plain and clear what it is. But yeah, there'll be a good one next weekend as well. So almost 800 are watching up the Alp. No way. Wow. If I'd have known that, I would have gone harder. No, I'm joking. I couldn't have gone any harder. Thank you, Elliot. Thank you, Alison. Yeah, looking forward to it, Tommy. It's five stages, Keith. We even do the tumble. So, you know, the Welsh climb, the tumble. We do that twice on the final stage. So, it's going to be a good one. Yeah. Cheers, Jeff. Are we done yet, Lord? Can I end the stream yet? Thank you, Moto. Oh, that's a good race, that, Steve. That's a good race, that. One of the longest races in the UK. I really enjoyed that race. Yeah. I am taking a rest day tomorrow as well, everyone. Just, you can be rest assured. I'm having a rest day tomorrow. They'll be on, I think it's 6:30 p.m. every day for those 5 days. So yeah. Lord is desperate for the 350s. So there it is, confirmed. The 345 is confirmed, which works out to about a 20-minute power of about 362. But I have a feeling that WKO is going to model differently because, yeah, I basically held over 360 for almost over half an hour. So could be possibly more. So 4 more likes. Well, my rest days are usually a short spin of around 45 minutes. I go and visit my granddad, who lives on his own. So I go and visit him on my rest days. Stand outside and have a chat, keep him company for a bit. So that's my rest days usually. It gives me an excuse to pedal. Yeah. It is a GC, Keith. Yeah, there's a general classification. So it's going to be interesting. Debbie Julian. Oh, I haven't written down. Good point. Quick, we'll just pedal a little bit. And then we'll ride up. Well remembered. I've disconnected my Harry monitor now, but. Yeah, that's it, Keith. Yeah, I use intervals ICU as well. I use lots of things, to be honest. I'm too much of a data nerd. Nice one. Thanks, everyone. Well done, everyone who's completed the whole route. Pretty incredible what you've done. Ah, it's disappeared. Put the leaderboard back up. Please. Come on. Yeah. 35:46. Crikey. There we go. Oh. Yeah, I've used exert as well. Yeah. Why aren't we aero tucking? That kit, no, it's the KOM, isn't it? Of the Alp. That's what that is, Agnes. That is the KOM jersey for the Alp. Yeah, took a photo of the leaderboard. I don't know why I'm not aero tucking. That's weird. Anyway. What was the result? You're manning the barbecue. The result was third, just, I think. We were like 20 seconds off the win, which is pretty nuts, actually, considering a couple of you were counting down that last like 2K. We were about 1 minute 15 down on first place. So, yeah.
Nope.
Still doesn't want to. Still doesn't want to talk. Because I weigh nothing. sorry, I didn't mean anything about the KOM jersey. I take a flipping heck, and he fell over then. Take a photo. I do like the Alp. The Alp is very nice. The air just goes straight through. I don't know why there's still so many of you here, so I'm just gonna drop this and you know. I'm going to enter the Struggle Dales. It's a sportif, but I mean, goodness knows, there's nothing on in the UK on the calendar. But this is on like end of May. Is it end of May? It'll be like 4 or 5 weeks out from the Marmot, if that is possible, if I'm able to go to it. So I'm going to enter. I'm going to enter that. Sidearm photos. Yeah. I don't know why. Some of you might be able to help me out here. Why is it when I take a photo in game, it doesn't automatically upload to Zwift, to Strava? Sorry. Why is that? Anyone got the answer? To select the photo. So if I take one here, like that, then I end ride, does it give me the option to select it then? So we get it. Oh, that's a shot there. That's a good shot. Ah, well, we'll see now. We'll try it live on the stream. I can get a another shot. Nice. Count myself as a photographer. No! What are you doing? Oh, that's done it now, innit? There we go. Bug on the effects F10 screenies, I believe, at the end before uploading. It's gonna take me forever to descend. Actually, we're nearly there now. So, yeah, I'm gonna do the struggle. I know Phil is doing it as well. I am also a little bit worried, actually, that I'm not going to be able to go to the Marmotte without the jab. I'm a little bit worried that I might not have it before July, and we might not be allowed to travel unless we have it. You alright?
I can get in the shower if you're not.
Why not?
I got a phone call at 7:30 as well. So.
I'm still alive.
Can I have dinner without you then? Because I'm starving.
You're gonna have dinner now, are you?
No, I'm gonna have a shower first, then I'll have dinner.
Yeah, I'll have dinner with you.
Okay.
It does look like a good event, David, yeah. Does look like a good event. Yeah, that's it, David. Yeah, get a bottle. Dragon Ride, yeah, that's a good shout, but they've closed the entries already. yeah, $5 too. Yeah, we know we'll have to see about the vaccine. Like, I'm sure I will get it before July, but there is something in the back of my mind that's like, you know, it doesn't take much for things to be uncertain and we can't go. The Marmotte is like the 27th of June or something like that. It's like the last weekend of June. So we're still going to the tourist stations this year in August. Fantastic event. So I haven't really planned anything before June because of everything. You always use the app to take a pic. Let me take a pic with the app then. Come on. Some 8-year-old stolen my. It's like if we took the photos then when we did. what was I gonna say? Charlie had hers. Obviously, she's working frontline NHS. But Charlie's got hers again. Next weekend, she's got her second and final jab next weekend. My dad had his a couple of days ago. He's in his 60s. Charlie's not sure who on Charlie's side has had it. Oh no, parents have had it recently. They're in their 60s. So we're nearly at the bottom. Nearly there. Apparently, there's a couple of, like, you know, we live in, well, fairly large, I don't know what you'd class a town as, but they've done a fair whack around here, like, they've done a fair amount of people, so... It's weird because I've some people who I know, I keep in touch with. Somebody lives like down south, South London way, like Surrey Hills, in his 40s, and he's had it, no underlying health conditions, just had a phone call from his surgery saying, yeah, it's your turn, and he's like, what, already? He thought it was a scam, you know, it was like so quick, so early. Okay, we hit the bottom. Menu. Android. Okay, so where do I select? Oh, cripes. What's that there? Where do I select these pictures in chat? So I go okay. There's obviously nothing there. So something is afoot. It's that thing at the end of your leg. Nice and Jeff. Let's call it Wow-E. Yeah, that's weird, isn't it? There we are. Well, it doesn't matter. We haven't got them, so. So that's 2/3 places we've had. So we'll call that third. There we go. I need to run it through the app. Oh well. Not to worry. Anyway, thanks for watching. Witness history. In the making. I'll see you. I got a video, nice video of me doing a 1 minute maximal effort tomorrow, and then the usual WTRL on Tuesday, and then I got a video on Wednesday of me and Charlie going to Swansea for hot chocolate on the beach. So stark contrast to what you've seen this weekend. Anyway, thanks for watching. And yeah, it's late already, so thank you very much. I'll see you then. Bye.